Williamson Wick Murray is an equally impressive American, a veteran, guest speaker at the PMML, and prominent professor at the Naval War College and United States Military Academy. He's receiving this Founders Award due to his immense contribution for furthering the public understanding of military history and affairs. Professor Murray has a long list of accomplishments, including serving as an officer in the U.S. Air Force, including a tour in Southeast Asia with the 314th Tactical Airlift Wing, C-130s. He then earned a PhD in military diplomatic history at Yale and taught there before moving on to Ohio State as a military and diplomatic historian, where he earned broad recognition for excellence, including the Alumni Distinguished Teaching Award. Professor Murray has also taught at several academic and military institutions, including the Air War College, the U.S. Military Academy, and the Naval War College. He served as a secretary of the Navy Fellow at the Naval War College, the Centennial Visiting Professor at the London School of Economics, and the Charles Lindbergh Chair at the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum. Unfortunately, Professor Murray could not be with us tonight, so please direct your attention to the screen. Thank you.
This is an enormous award, and I'm both honored and delighted to have received it. The Pritzker Library is one of the few places which has given recognition to the importance of military history, both to the history of the world as well as to American history. And with what's happening in our schools and universities with the disappearance of serious military history, I think the Pritzker Library is going to play in a more and more important role. My first few months in Vietnam and Thailand convinced me that I really wanted to study military history, because the mistakes that we were clearly making in Vietnam at this time had reached the point, I think, both in terms of what one saw and what one read, that I really wanted to study military history, because I thought that it would be a very important way to prevent the United States from making the same mistakes. The chance to study history through documents and through secondary sources and through interviews with people gives a historian a unique ability, if you will, to unravel, if you will, the puzzle of the past, what happened to the extent that that's possible. I think in a larger sense, unraveling the past should be, if it's read by those in the present or those preparing for leadership in the future, should prepare them not to make the kinds of mistakes that have been made in the past. I feel enormously honored, and I'm still hard at work, almost 80, in turning out history books, which I think, as long as I have a brain that works, I will be doing.